Patrick Barlow weaves a tapestry of mystery, comedy, and suspense that dances on the thin line between reality and illusion. In this enigmatic tale, a seemingly ordinary man is thrust into a web of espionage, where ordinary objects and chance encounters take on extraordinary significance. Is it a daring espionage adventure, a captivating romance, or an intricate puzzle waiting to be deciphered? With each step, as the line between the protagonist and the antagonist blurs, it reveals the complexities of human nature. Prepare to be captivated, bewildered, and utterly enthralled as the Dune School English Dramatic Society presents to you The 39 Steps.
August 1935. I've been back 3 months in the old country and frankly wondering why. The weather made me liverish, no exercise to speak of, and the talk of the ordinary Englishman made me sick. I've had enough of restaurants and parties and race car meetings. No pal to go bash with, which probably explains things. Hoppy Binge, lost in the Canadian Treasury. Tommy Del Rey, married off to a blonde heiress in Chicago. And Chips Carruthers, eaten by crocodiles in the Limpopo. Leaving me, Richard Hannay, about 37 years old, sound in wind and limb. Back home, which was no home at all, if you want to ask. Just a dull little rented flat in West One. Portland Place, actually. And I was bored. No more than bored, tired. Tired of the world and tired of life, to be honest. So I called my broker. He wasn't in. Dropped into my club, full of all colonial buffers. Had a scotch and soda. Picked up an evening paper, put it back. Full of elections and wars and rumors of wars. And I thought, who the bloody hell cares, frankly? What happens to anyone? What happens to me? No one would miss me. I wouldn't miss me. I could quite easily just... And then I thought, wait a minute, Hannay. Pull yourself together, man. Find something to do, you bloody fool. Something mindless and trivial. Something utterly pointless. Something I know. A West End show. That should do the trick. Oh. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. How are we tonight? And now, with your kind attention, I have the immense honor and privilege of presenting to you one of the most remarkable men of the century, Mr. Memory! Every day, Mr. Memory commits to memory 15 new facts and remembers every single one of them. Facts from history and from geography, facts from newspapers and scientific books. In fact, more facts is in his brain than is possible to conceive. Now then, are you ready for the questions, Mr. Memory?
Quite ready for the questions, but before I begin, I'd like to clear my inner being of all extrinsic and supernumerary material. Ready?
First question, please. Oh, come on now. Please don't be shy. What was that, sir?
Who won the cup in
1926? Mr. Memory.
Who won the cup in 1926? I got it! The Tottenham Hotspurs won the cup in 1926, defeating the Arsenal Gunners by 5-0 in the presence of His Majesty, King George V. Am I right, sir?
Quite right, Mr. Memory, quite right.
Thank you.
Next question, please. Oh, yes, sir.
What was
Napoleon's horse called, Mr. Memory?
What was Napoleon's horse called? Page 186, NBB. Bellerophon! Bellerophon was the name of Napoleon's horse, what he rode for the final time at Waterloo, June 15th, 1815. Am I right, sir?
Quite right, Mr. Memory, quite right.
Thank you.
Next question, please. Oh, yes, sir?
How old is Mae West,
Mr. Memory?
How old is Mae West? Well, I know, sir, but I never tell a lady's age.
Yeah! As a gentleman. Very good, very good. Now then, a serious question, please.
I say.
Oh, what was that, sir?
How far is Winnipeg from Montreal?
How far is Winnipeg from Montreal, Mr. Memory?
How far is Winnipeg from Montreal? 1,457 miles. Am I right, sir?
Quite right, Mr. Memory, quite right.
Thank you.
Next question, please.
William Beckford Montreal, 1,457
miles. Sit down, bring all
your articles. Am I right, sir?
Oh, you're right.
I never tell a lady
that. That was Mr. Memory.
Am I right, sir?
Thank you.
That was a weird show, wasn't it?
Excuse me?
Yes?
May I come home with you, please?
Well, what's the big idea?
Well, I'd like to.
You see, I've got the decorators in. I really can't.
Please, you have to.
Well,
please.
Your funeral. Just, don't mind the door.
Right.
I can never find the switch, damn it.
Oh. Turn it off, quickly. Oh, scheiße. Blind!
Sorry?
Blind! Pull down the blind!
Oh, the blind! Yes, of course, the blind. I am so sorry. Oh, that's better, isn't it?
Now the lights, Mr. Hannay.
Yes. Oh. Wow. Alcoholic much? Yes, thank you. Okay. A little bit more. Ah, fantastic.
Hello, that's your
phone. Don't answer it, please.
Why not?
Because I think it is for me. I said don't answer!
Now look here.
Yes.
Am I allowed to know your name?
You don't want to know my name.
Do I?
Schmidt.
Schmidt.
Annabella Schmidt.
So what's the story, Annabella Schmidt?
Mr. Hannay.
Yes?
May I be very impertinent for a moment and ask you something to eat?
Oh, well, of course. Would you care for some haddock?
Haddock? Oh, that would be wunderbar. Thank you.
Nothing like a spot of haddock. Wait. Now look here.
Yes.
It was you who fired that revolver in the theatre, wasn't it? I mean, it wasn't a great show, but it wasn't that bad.
It was a diversion, Mr. Hannay. There were two men in the theatre trying to shoot me.
Well, you should be more careful in choosing your gentlemen friends.
Not just Mr. Hannay, please.
Beautiful, mysterious woman pursued by gunmen. Sounds like a spy story.
Mr. Hannay, please, you have to believe me. I'm being pursued by a brilliant foreign agent.
Yes, I get
it. On the point of obtaining highly confidential information right up to your air defense. I tracked two of his men to that music hall. Unfortunately, they recognized me.
Ever heard of a thing called persecution mania?
You don't believe me.
Frankly, I don't.
They are in the street at this moment, beneath your English lamppost. Take a look, why don't you? But be careful. Secret and highly confidential information is out of the country. You how clever the chief is. I know him very well. He has a dozen names. He can turn into 100 people. But one thing he cannot disguise. This part of his little finger, Mr. Hannay, this little finger is missing. So if you ever should meet a man with no top joint here, be very careful, my friend.
I remember that.
Mr. Hannay.
Richard.
Richard.
Yes?
May I stay the night, please?
Oh, of course. You can sleep in my bed.
Thank you.
I gotta shake down the armchair.
As you wish. Oh, and one more thing.
Your haddock.
My haddock. No, I rather lost the taste for haddock. I need a map of Scotland.
A map of Scotland?
There is this man in Scotland who I must visit next if anything is to be done. An Englishman. He lives in a big house.
A big house?
At a place called Ardashala. Oh.
I beg your pardon.
Arsnashalach!
Arsnashalach in the 39.
Bring it to my room.
Certainly.
Good night, Richard.
Good night, Annabella.
Blimey, mate! What's you up to? I nearly died of fright.
Because you used a pound note, brother.
Pound note? Pound note? What's the catch?
I need your cap and coat.
Cap and cone? Cap and cone? What's the game? Spit it out!
I need to make a getaway!
To a bunk?
Yes!
What you been up to?
Okay. I'm gonna have to trust you, There's been a murder committed on the first floor.
A murder? A murder! By you! By you!
Oh, no. Wait, there's two men over there.
I see.
So now they're waiting good as gold for a copper to come, eh?
It's true, I tell you. They're spies, foreigners. They murdered a woman in my flat and now they're waiting for me.
Ah, come off it. Funny jokes at 5 o'clock in the morning.
All right. I'll tell you the truth, Are you married?
Yes, but that's one I regret.
Well, I'm not, you see. I'm a bachelor.
Lucky you.
But I've been seeing this married woman.
Naughty.
Point is,
yeah.
She was leading me on.
No.
It was all a setup.
Would you believe it?
Oh, you see, there's two men over there.
I do.
One's a brother, the other's a husband.
Oh, blimey. I wouldn't be in your shoes. Here, I'm a cap and coat.
Oh, thank you, mate. I'll never forget you for this.
How'd you get yourself in that sticky situation?
Oh, right.
Eh?
You know what? Have a pound.
A pound? That's very kind of you.
You know what? Take two.
2 pounds. God bless you, girl. Leave the pony round the corner. Wait a minute. That's my money you just gave me. Boy, come back here. Why are you running off to?
Hello there. Knock. Who's there?
Not your father.
Well, yeah, he'll have to get the milk.
Thanks, spirit.
Anyway, where are we now?
Here we are, Edinburgh town.
Well,
Who won the dog locket event, sir?
You know what? I'll get a paper.
I'll go to the lavatory.
Excuse me.
Evening Bible, latest news. Evening Bible, sir.
Evening paper, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Just one, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Evening Bible, latest news. Evening Bible.
Ah, he's back.
Excuse me, sorry.
You go there.
No, my God.
Hello. Check this out.
Good Lord.
What is it? Been a woman murdered in a fashionable West End flat. Stabbed in the back, she was. Portland mansions. Portland place.
What was she like?
One of the usual.
Yes, one of the usual. A well-dressed woman about 35.
Terrible.
Anyway, the suspect, Richard Hannay, is still missing.
Boy, sure to surprise me.
He has dark straight hair, piercing brown eyes, and a very sharp nose.
Might I have a look at your paper?
He has a sharp nose.
Are you the murderer?
Certainly not.
Are you the murderer?
Certainly not. Anyways, I'm gonna go pop out to the buffet car. Fancy anything?
No, thank you.
You! Finish?
Yes, thank you.
Fancy anything?
No, thank you.
Cool.
Cheerio. Oh, good Lord! Raise the civil police. Excuse me, Constable. Got the West End murderer yet?
We will catch him, don't you worry, sir.
That's the spirit.
Anything suspicious, you let us know first.
Will do, Constable.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
All aboard for the Highlands.
All
aboard
now
for the Highlands. Someone, please, the Highlands. And anything suspicious, you let us know first.
Will do, Constable.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir.
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 All aboard for the Highlands. Someone, please, the Highlands. Someone, just the Highlands, please.
Final edition, sir.
No, thank you, sir. All aboard for the Highlands. Someone, please, the Highlands. All aboard.
Roger, stop it already.
Thank you.
Excuse me, sorry.
Now you get up.
Go on, my gosh. Sit up, Daddy.
Hello.
Hello.
Back to the buffet car. Guess what?
What?
The police are searching every compartment.
Every compartment? Well, here's what we do. There's a massive man's up there.
Excuse me. Sorry.
Hair, piercing brown eyes, and an oddly attractive sharp nose.
We make the ladies all vigilant because we are very sorry for them too, because it is not known whether they survived the ordeal or not, as police had to call off the search in the gathering darkness.
Who's disturbing me?
Please, I really need your help.
Yes. Yes.
Hello there.
Can I help you?
Yes, I'm looking for work.
What kind of work?
I'm an itinerant laborer.
You'll find nothing in this vicinity.
Are there no big houses around here?
No big houses.
Wait, so what's that big house?
What big house?
That big house. That big house.
That's big house.
That's big house.
That is a big house, all right.
So who's house
is that then? A professor, I believe. Professor Jordan.
An Englishman. An Englishman. It would be called, that's a laugh, would it?
It would.
Maybe. I'll head on there. Cheerio, mate.
You won't tonight. It's nearly 14 miles. The other side of the lock.
No, thank you. I'm sure I'll be fine.
Margaret!
Oh, listen here, mate.
Come here. We have a visitor.
Dare you.
Good evening, sir.
Oh, good evening.
You could stay the night if you wanted.
Well, on second thoughts, that'd be very kind.
Can you eat the herring?
I can murder half a dozen right now.
You sleep in a box bed?
I can try.
216?
Done.
See to the gentleman on the left and be quick about it.
Your daughter?
That's my wife!
Oh, well, done.
Won't you come in, please?
Supper ready, woman?
Almost.
Hurry yourself.
Might I have a look at your paper?
Suit yourself.
Thank you so much.
You didn't tell me your name, mister.
Oh, yes. Hammond.
Mr. O. Hammond?
No, Hammond.
That's a weird name.
Lovely.
I'll say a blessing before we begin. Settle down.
O most mighty and unforgiving Father, sanctify these bounteous and undeserved mercies to us miserable sinners. Make us bow on bended knee and truly thankful for all thy manifold blessings.
Beat our gluttonous thoughts, lash our lustful desires, as with a 3-4 flailing stick, pressing our bestial noses to the grindstone and the tawdry beads and baubles of all worldly wicked things. Amen.
Amen.
I forgot to lock the barn. I'll go and lock it, all right?
Right, okay.
To know, I'm on the run from the police.
The police?
They're after me for murder.
Murder? Police?
Don't let them in. I'll make it worth your while.
How much?
£5.
In cash?
Will you take check?
Don't be funny with me.
Fine. Pay him.
Greedy.
I don't trust him. Listen. I was right. He's double-crossing you. Quick, through the door. Not that door.
Oh, then which door?
The rear door.
Oh, bad door.
Wait.
What?
Your jacket.
My jacket.
It's terribly light-colored.
Well, it's the latest Harris tweed.
I'm afraid they'll see you on the dark moors. Best take this one.
Oh,
But this is your husband's couch.
Aye, his Sunday's best. It's so dark they'll never see you.
What's this?
His hymn book.
Oh, well, I can sing a hymn if I get frightened.
Don't joke, I beg of you.
What happened to you?
Don't worry about me.
I wish I could take you away from all of this.
No, this is my home.
What's your name?
Margaret.
Thank you, Margaret. I'll never forget you for this. Oh!
Breaking news! Richard Hannay, suspected of committing murder in the Portland Place case, has just been spotted on the harbours of Aberdeen. Police have warned that he's certainly armed and dangerous. Here is his description once again. The suspect is approximately 37 and about 6'2", with dark straight hair, piercing brown eyes and a very attractive sharp nose. His time on the harbours has made him slightly more rugged looking, actually, which makes him even more noticeably attractive.
Oh, thanks, mate.
Hello? Is anyone there? Please?
Yes.
Oh, hello. I'm looking for the professor. Professor Jordan.
Oh, Professor Jordan. I'm the professor's wife, Louisa Jordan.
Oh, well, hello, miss. Is the professor there? It's really quite important.
May I know your name?
Oh, yes. My name is, Hammond. Tell him I'm a friend of Miss Annabella Schmidt.
Miss Annabella Schmidt. Come in, Mr. Hammond, if you would, please.
Yes. Oh, wow. Lovely house.
Oh, we love it. We're just having a few drinks with some friends to celebrate my daughter Hillary's birthday. A number of well-to-do acquaintances of my husband, including the sheriff of the county. Oh. Later, we're organizing a shooting party. Perhaps you'd care to join?
Oh, yes, of course. Thank you so much.
Shall we pop into the party, then?
Where's the door?
Just a second. Shall we pop into the party?
Oh, of course.
On second thoughts, Mr. Hammond, if you wouldn't mind waiting in here, I'll go fetch my husband directly.
Oh, it's quite all right. Thank you so much.
You, Mr. Hammond.
Oh, it's quite all right.
So you're from
Annabella Schmidt, isn't it?
Yes, I am.
Ah, well, do you have any news?
She's been murdered,
oh dear.
Of course, murdered. Ah, the Portland Mansions case, am I right?
Ah, quite dreadful. And let me guess, the police are after you.
Yes, they are rather.
Well, don't you worry. I have managed to put them
off the scent.
They'd be far away, man.
Oh, thanks awfully, mate.
Not at all, old chap, not at all.
I didn't do it.
Of course you did not, Mr. Richard Hannay.
Wait, I suppose it's quite all right to call you by your
real name now, Mr. Richard Hannay.
Oh, yes, quite safe.
So tell me, Mr. Richard Hannay, why have you come all the way to Scotland to tell me about this?
Because I believe she was trying to tell you about some top secret, vital information, secret... Secret. Oh, and she was killed by a foreign agent who was interested to you.
Oh, really?
Yes.
Well, I'm glad you've told me. Oh. And risking your life into the bargain, Mr. Richard Hannay, you must be quite a brave man.
Thank you.
How could I ever thank you?
It's quite all right, Professor. But I believe she was trying to tell you about something, Professor.
Go on.
Something called,
Yes?
Ah, the 39th step. We can find out what the 39th step... Is that a gun?
So let me get this quite clear, Mr. Richard Hannay. Actually, you must be quite exhausted by now. Please, have a seat. I insist, Mr. Hannay. Please have a seat. I insist. So did she tell you what did this foreign agent look like, perhaps?
Well, that wasn't time, but she did tell me one thing. Part of his little finger was missing.
Which little finger, Mr. Hannay?
This one, I think.
Are you sure, Mr. Hannay? It wasn't this one!
I'm not sure. I think,
I'm afraid, Mr. Hannay, I've been guilty of leading you down the garden path. Or should I say, up the garden path. You see, I can never remember.
It seems to be the wrong garden, all right.
Of course, Mr. Hannay, of course. You forced me into a really difficult position, Mr. Hannay. You see, I live here as a respectable citizen of the country. My very best friend is the sheriff of the county. But you know, my whole existence could be in jeopardy, Mr. Hannay. Mr. Hannay, don't you run away like that, Mr. Hannay. Come back here. Where was I again?
Jeopardized.
Jeopardy, yes, Mr. Hannay. My whole existence could be in jeopardy, Mr. Hannay, if it became known. How shall I say? If it became known that I'm not what I seem to be, you see? Yeah. But you see, what makes it doubly important, Mr. Hannay, is that I simply can't let you go. Today, I'm about to convey some really vital information out of the country, and I've done it. I've done it, Mr. Hannay. I've done it all right. Poor Annabella. Poor Annabella. She would be quite too late by now. Mr. Hannay. You see, there's only one option left, Mr. Hannay.
Oh, no.
Ah, there you are, dear. Anyways, I'll be serving lunch directly. The chef has to go at 3. Will Mr. Hammond be staying?
I don't think so, dear. Unless, of course, Mr. Hannay, you decide to join us.
For lunch?
Very good, Mr. Hannay. Very good. You see, you're the exact person we need. Sharp, intelligent, cold-blooded, ruthless. And when the war comes, Mr. Hannay, these are the exact qualities we would need.
War?
Yes, Mr. Hannay. There's going to be quite a show of it.
And what if I don't believe in those qualities?
Well, Mr. Hannay, what other qualities are there?
Human qualities,
Mr. Hannay. What human qualities?
Loyalty, selflessness, sacrifice.
And let me guess, love, perhaps?
Love.
Love. Love, Mr. Hannay, love. When have you ever loved anyone? When has anyone ever loved you, Mr. Hannay? It's not in your nature, old sport. Never has been, has it? Do you have any heart, Mr. Hannay, do you? So sad, isn't it? No home to go to. No one to love, no one to care for. But there you see it, Mr. Hannay, there's our home.
Our
home, Mr. Hannay, home. Where you really and truly belong, Mr. Hannay. Oh, we will give you all the love, Mr. Hannay. We will give you the love. And in return, you will love us. The master race commanded eternally by destiny itself. What a great and stubborn march, Mr. Hannay. Will you join us, Mr. Hannay, will you? What do you say, Osborne? Will you join us?
Well, if you think I'm suitable material.
Of course, Mr. Hannay, of course, of course. I'll just go and tell Miss Jordan.
I just have one question.
Of course, Mr. Hannay, of
just,
course.
Just one little
absolutely
question.
Absolutely.
Before I
absolutely,
my what exactly is
yes, the 39 steps, Mr. Hannay? To I say it myself is absolutely my own brilliant idea. The very soul of the enterprise, the very... But wait a second. Wait a minute, Mr. Hannay. You think you can pull the fool? You think you can join us
in the... master race and inspire him!
You think, grandmother she was, Arabella Schmidt, with all her outmoded sentimental notions, her high-minded boy shy as a dribble. You petty-minded pussy Larimus pathetic.
No.
Oh my God, oh dear. Someone give me a gun that works, bro.
No, why would you give him a gun?
Oh.
No. No. Oh, fucker.
Dad, Annie? The 39 steps. You will never know, Richard Hannay.
Oh, wow. At last he's dead. Good job, honey.
Pocket watches, spectacle holders, but never a hymn book, Mr. Hannay.
Oh, right? Who would have thought a hymn book could have stopped a bullet?
No one!
Still, I'm not surprised. Some of these hymns are terribly hard to get to.
Right.
And to think me, of all people, was drinking the villain champagne. Only what? Half an hour ago?
Right?
Oh, I can barely believe it. Tea, Mr. Hannay?
No, thank you.
calling himself a professor, whereas all along he was a...
A spy!
Oh. Well, it's a lesson to us all. Pretty slick sleuthing for an amateur, Mr. Hannay.
Thank you. But listen here, Sheriff. Ought we be taking steps to arrest him, you see? I wouldn't trust myself with a murder charge hanging over me, would I?
Never heed the murder, Mr. Hannay. All I need from you is a small statement. And I've got someone from the police station coming down to get that. Wow. You'll be in Clearwater soon enough.
Thank you so much. But listen here, Sheriff. Yeah. Look, he's about to reveal some very vital information out of this country. And if you don't suddenly help me, you know, like...
Are you wishing to see me, Sheriff?
Indeed I am, Inspector. Do you think I enjoy playing time with a murderer?
Murderer? Where?
You?
No, you.
Where? For me? Richard Hannay, you are under arrest for the willful murder of a woman unknown in the Portland Mansions affair of Tuesday last. Take him to the country.
Why, but you heard my story is true, everywhere of it.
We're not such imbeciles in Scotland as some smart Londoners might think. I don't believe your cock and bull story about the professor for one single second. Why? He's my best friend in the district. Get me, Professor Jordan.
Well,
now.
If the professor didn't shoot me, then where did this bullet come from? It's a bullet. It's a bullet, mate. It's a bullet. No, what? Stop.
You're in deep water now, Mr. Hannay. And it's getting deeper by a second. Yes, this is the sheriff of the county. And I'll thank you too. Yes, Professor. Yes, I'm just calling to inform you. Indeed, we have, sir. Sir, yes, sir. We have apprehended the villain, sir.
Listen here. I demand that you allow me to speak to the Foreign Office in London.
Foreign Office in London? I think not, Mr. Hannay. Handcuffs, Inspector, please.
This one.
Handcuffs going on right now, sir.
Are you okay? Hannay!
He's escaped! He escaped! Stop him!
Everything sticky, Leeboo, sir. Sir, yes, sir. Don't you worry, sir. Sleep well, sir. Yes, sir.
Since I've clapped.
Well, hello there, ladies and gentlemen. I must apologize for my hesitation in addressing all of you, because to tell you the simple truth, I'd entirely failed while listening to the chairman's flattering description about me to realize he was talking about me. Thank you very much. Anyway, when I journeyed up to Scotland a few days ago and passed over that magnificent Forth Bridge, I had no idea that in a few days, I'd be addressing an important political meeting. But to tell you the entire truth, I am so humble and relieved to find myself in your presence at this very moment. Oh, hello, do take a seat. Oh. It's the one from the train, isn't it?
Oh, my God.
Yes, it is.
Oh, my God.
Anyway, what was I saying?
Moment.
Oh, yes, moment. Because I am so humbled and relieved to find myself in your presence at this very moment. Because I believe that you are a real people who care about each other, right? Let's have a word where no neighbor plots against no neighbor, where no nation plots against no nation, where there's no persecution of any kind, where everybody deserves a sporting chance and a good deal. Is that such a bad word? Is that such an outmoded sentimental notion? Is it? Because I'm asking each and every one of you here tonight. Yes, you and definitely you. What sort of world do you want to see? Because I want to see a kind world full of morals. So let's vote for it. Vote for a good world, a new one. And above all, vote for Mr.
Crocodile! That's it, Frank! That's it! Oh.
Words, where have I heard those words before?
Get him!
Wait! Where'd he go? Where'd you? Tell me! Where'd he go?
Are you kidding me?
That's not fair! He went there!
You think you've been damn clever?
Officer, can't you tell your prisoner not to insult me, please?
Come along now.
Listen,
sir.
I was speaking the truth in that anyway. Surely you must have heard that I was genuine.
Okay, and that will be all now. Thank you very much for the help, miss.
Don't mention it. Goodbye, officers.
Listen. They're about to reveal vital information out of this country, and if you don't help me...
Goodbye, Mr. Hannay!
On second thoughts, miss...
Edwards.
Oh, right. On second thoughts, Miss Edwards, we might want you to come to the police station, miss.
Me?
Yes.
Whatever
for? To identify the prisoner, miss.
But I just told
you. Just to the police station, miss.
If you wouldn't mind, miss.
If you wouldn't mind, miss.
Well, where is the police
station? Inverary, miss.
Inverary, but that's nearly...
40 miles off.
40 miles?
You stay out of this.
He is to be questioned by the Procurator Fiscal personally, miss.
Procurator Fiscal personally?
Oh, it's essential for public security, miss.
Essential for public security?
If you wouldn't mind, miss.
Well, if it's absolutely necessary...
Right. Well, splendid then. If you wouldn't mind getting into the car.
The car. The car.
Where?
Oh, get into the damn car.
Where?
The car.
Where is the car?
The car.
Go, 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 go,
and hiding up.
Wait, where's the wheel?
I don't know.
car.
What?
Oh, sit down. Get up now. Yes.
Why? Stop that. Shoot you stone dead.
No, definitely no.
Then let's have a move on.
What? Officer!
They got away.
Yes, I can see that, but where?
I don't know.
Me neither.
But if we don't find them,
will you complete your sentence?
Our lives won't be worth living.
Oh my God!
Wait!
What?
The car.
Where?
The car.
Where is it?
Here, you buffoon.
Thanks. Here.
Take it!
Taking it!
Gotta find them!
Oh!
I just said that!
That hurt! And I know you just said that!
Well, don't say it again, you fool!
Oh, sorry.
Oh, take it!
Taking it!
I think they went that way!
Then get them!
Oh, Hannay!
It's a terrible Highland night, Willie.
Aye.
All the rain and wind rushing down the glen. Wouldn't want to be out there alone tonight.
No.
Hello?
Hear that?
Aye.
Hello?
There it goes again.
Hello?
Aye, poor dear. Look, Willie. It's a young couple come out of the night. Come away in, sir. Come away in. Oh, my poor young lass is terrible. Where? My poor wee dear.
Oh, yes. We just had a car accident.
Have you no luggage?
Sorry?
Have you no luggage?
Have ye no luggage? Oh, yes, of course. It's in the car.
In the car, of course. Anyway, welcome to the McGarrigan Hotel.
Oh.
My name is Mrs. McGarrigan. And this is my husband, Willie.
Hi.
McGarrigan.
Hi. Anyway,
you can be certain that here you get the best McGarrigan welcome.
Wow, thank you.
Isn't that right, Willie?
Aye. That's absolutely amazing.
Despite it being off season.
Okay. So could you please accommodate us for the night?
Oh, well, let us see.
Well, we've just the one bedroom left with their one bed in it. But you'll not be minding that.
Oh, no, 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 quite the reverse.
You are a man and wife, I suppose.
Oh, yes, of course. Darling?
Yes.
I thought you were, I thought you were. If you would name mind registering, please, we'll lay the book.
Aye. Oh, you see, I have a bit of a problem with my right hand. It's, you know, like bruised. Sorry?
Cranking the car.
Oh, yes, cranking the car, cranking the car. Tell you what, why don't you sign, my darling? The sooner you get used to writing your new name, the better. Remember what it was?
No.
Oh, I think you do, don't you? Mr. and Mrs. Henry Hopkinson. Oh, well done.
And there we are.
Well, let's go.
Will you be needing your suppers?
Sorry?
Will you be needing your suppers?
Will you be needing your supper?
Oh, yes, of course, of course. If you could send a whiskey and a few sandwiches. Oh, and a glass of milk.
Of course, of course. Ah, the young dogs. Would you care to follow me to your room now, please?
Of course, please lead the way.
Of course.
Darling?
Daisy. Well, anyway, here we are, all ready for you. A fine, roaring fire.
Oh, wow, marvelous.
Now, dearie, take that skirt off. It's terrible wet. Oh,
no, thank you. It'll be dry by the fireplace soon. Thanks, all the same.
No doubt the gentleman will take good care of you. Good night, sir. Good night, madam.
Good night.
Look, if you think I'm going to spend the whole night with you in that bed!
Well, what else are you going to do? Huh?
Let me go!
Oh, just stop it already.
Let me go!
It's hurting me!
I don't care!
Oh, what do you mean, girl? You don't care?
Uh-huh! A water on the rack!
Oh, yes, come in!
Oh, my God!
Oh, excuse me!
Oh, yes. We were just getting warmer by the fire. Weren't we, darling?
What?
Weren't we, darling?
Yes, yes.
Darling!
Darling!
Oh, I can see that. Anyway, here's your wee sandwiches, your whiskey, and a glass of milk.
Oh, thank you so much.
Will there be anything else?
No.
Well, then enjoy yourself, dearies.
I said, please don't go!
Whatever's the matter, dearie?
Oh, nothing's the matter, nothing's the matter. It's just that, we're a runaway couple.
Oh, I kenned it all the time.
Sorry?
I kenned it all the time.
Oh, so you wouldn't rat us out, will you?
Of course we and I won't rat you out. Your secret's safe with us. You'll never be disturbed.
Yes, of course, sir.
Good night, sir.
Good night. Well then, come along now. Come along now. Let's have some food. Would you like the ham and tomato or the ham and tomato?
Ham and tomato.
Ham and tomato it is. Then I'll have the ham and tomato. Ladies first. Get those stockings off.
I beg your pardon?
Listen, I don't want a pneumonia case on top of everything else.
Just take it off. I don't mind.
No, thank you. Actually, I'll take my shoes off.
Right.
And my stockings.
Of course. Can I be of any assistance?
Hold this.
All right. Oh,
Okay. Oh. Wanna have a glass of milk?
Fine.
Warmer now?
Thanks.
Well then, come along now.
What are you doing?
Going to bed.
Certainly not. I'm not going in that bed.
Well, as long as you're chained to me, you go where I go. I'm sorry.
What?
Wait. That's better, isn't it? Ah. Come on, I clean it for you. Oh, just sit down, will you? That's better, isn't it?
I want you to know, I hate you.
Right. You are my fire, the one desire. Believe when I say I want.
Stop singing!
Oh, I'm sorry, I just can't get that damn song out of my head. I wonder where I heard it. Want to know when I last slept in a bed, Pamela? Saturday night, that was. Whenever that was. That time I only got a couple of hours.
What woke you? Dreams? I suppose murderers have terrible dreams.
Oh, I used to think that the police were after me. Funny that. You see, when I first took to a life of crime, I was quite squeamish about it. A most sensitive child.
You do surprise me.
But soon I got hardened. And before I knew it, I was an out-and-out villain, wanted in 3 continents. One day you might take your grandchildren to Madame Tussauds and point me out.
Which section?
The inveterate. The no-hoppers. Ask me, Pamela, my darling. Poor little orphan boy who never had a chance. Irredeemable. Irreclaimable. Unreformable. Utterly horrid and beastly. I'd get away as far as away as you can if I was you, Pamela. Oh, wait. You can't, can you? Anyway, you know what? I'm feeling a bit sleepy. Good night, and I'm taking the pillow.
Always get
yet, car.
Aye. Oh, can I help ye?
Yes. Yes, you can help me. This was rather convenient.
I know. I was listening. I mean, it's just a hotel owner's instinct.
Right. Anywho, I was wondering, sir, that if you... One moment. If you might have had... If you might have had a young couple staying here tonight.
Might have had happened to... Had. A mighty young couple staying over
yes,
here tonight.
Yes, hurry up now.
Well, now that you mention it.
Yes.
But can I take your coat, by the way?
Yes, my coat. Thank you very much.
This is a coat, not a Christmas.
Then get it off, will you? Happy?
No.
Good.
Well, now that you mention it.
Right.
We do have a boy.
What are you doing out there?
The gentleman wanted
standing
to
standing there in your nightgown for all the world to see. Put your coat on and tidy yourself. And as for ye?
Yes.
Whoever ye are.
Whoever I am.
I'll thank you to get out of me hoose.
What?
Waking people up all hours of the night. Have you no bed to go to?
Lady, you don't know who you are messing with. I can call the very sheriff.
Shut up and good night.
But the sheriff of the county,
I said shut up and good night.
So you want me to go then?
Yes.
But the sheriff of the county.
What about him?
Nothing. You know what? I am going. Good night. And I'm very proud of this
night. It's always happening. Bonkers talking to a lady like that.
I despise people like that. I definitely do.
Now, dear Willie.
I...
You neg your weird, dear young couple, would you?
No.
You old fool, you. To your bed, man.
What happened? How did you get out of these? Why didn't you run away?
Well, I did. But just as I was going, I discovered you were telling the truth.
May I ask what earthquake caused your brain to work at last?
Two policemen came here last night. The ones from the car. I overheard them telephoning someone. They're not real policemen.
I know they weren't real policemen. I told you they weren't real policemen.
Sorry.
Fine. So what did they say?
Oh, a lot of stuff. Something with a number. What was it? 39 steps. They're going to warn them.
What?
How can you warn steps?
Never mind. Go on.
Oh, they did say a lot of other stuff. Someone's got the wind up and is clearing out. I know, they're picking someone up from the London Palladium.
The London Palladium? But why would anyone want to go to the London Palladium? Is it our friend with his little finger missing?
Mm-hmm.
But why would he want to go there? Funny thing for a master spy to do, isn't it?
Well, I'm terribly sorry for being such an awful fool, for not having believed you.
Oh, well, it's quite all right.
Well?
So, which room are they staying in?
Who?
Those two men.
They're not.
What?
They drove off after they had telephoned. Rather fast, actually.
So where did they go?
Don't know. Sorry. Does it matter?
Does it matter?
What?
What do you mean, does it matter? What? Oh, you button-headed little idiot.
What?
Oh, my goodness. This is unbelievably appalling. Oh, so where did they go?
I don't know. The London Palladium, I suppose.
The London Palladium? When?
Tonight, on the way out!
On the way out? On the way out of what?
I don't know what!
Oh, well, thanks for your help. That's four of my precious hours wasted. Oh, you! Oh, my God.
But if they're gone, just leave them well alone. It's all fine, right? It's all fine.
Leave them well alone. I'm accused of murder. The only way to clear my name was to expose those spies.
There you go again, you see, culprit, utterly horrid and beastly, and selfish!
But much more important than that, much more important than clearing my name, they're about to reveal vital information out of this country!
Oh.
Bella, very, very sorry.
Oh, so which-o, Martini or evening?
I don't know what.
Oh, thanks for your help. Goodbye.
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 Oh. And don't expect me to come with you.
Oh, I won't.
Enjoy the show.
You ran off.
You ran off.
Well, I was bloody furious.
Oh, yes, leave them.
Oh, no. Now that you're here, just stay.
All right.
Okay. You know our professor with his little finger missing?
Yes.
Well, I spotted him.
There.
Oh, not again.
Why?
Gosh, yes. But wait a minute.
What?
I've been to Scotland Yard.
You've been to Scotland Yard?
Yes, my uncle's the chief commissioner there.
Your uncle's chief commissioner?
Mm-hmm. Uncle Bob.
Uncle Bob.
Yes, and he said nothing's been stolen from the Air Ministry. No information or anything.
But you heard those two men saying that the professor's got it.
They checked everything and they're absolutely certain about it.
Oh, the police! Why are they here? They didn't follow you here, did they, Pamela?
Gosh, sorry.
Oh, that's it. Oh.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. How are we? Where's the seal? Oh, cleanup squad! Oh, where's the cleanup? You know what? You're fired! Get out! Mr. Memory! New facts and remembers every single one of them. Facts from history and from geography, facts from newspapers and scientific books. In fact, more facts is in his brain than is possible to conceive. Now then, are you ready for the questions, Mr. Memory?
Quite ready for the questions, but before I begin, I'd like to clear my inner being of all extrinsic and supernumerary material. Thank you.
First question, please. Oh, come on now, please. Oh, what was that, sir?
Who built the St. Paul's Cathedral?
Who built the St. Paul's Cathedral? Mr. Memory.
Who built the St. Paul's Cathedral? I know. Sir Christopher Wren.
Hello there. You know what?
Keep this.
So sorry to disturb the show. I am Detective Chief Inspector Albright. And I am looking for a... Not you. I am looking for a... Richard Hannay.
Oh, yes, that's me, that's me.
Oh, that's you.
Oh, that's me, that's me. Yeah, that's me too.
Nice to meet you. So, you are actually under arrest for...
But you don't understand, Chief Inspector Albright.
I think I do, miss.
He's innocent.
Oh, it's fine, Pamela. All right, I'll have it with you, Albright.
Very wise, sir. Now, if you just... Where are you running off to?
Don't mind me.
I'm not even looking for you. Why are you running? Did they just escape? They did.
That'd be the right answer.
I know it is. Wait, they escape!
Oh, yes!
Oh! They'll take my badge. My cap. They'll take my badge. I know. Block all of the exits. Block every single exit. Right now, please continue on, Mr. Memory.
Mr. Memory.
Right. Before being interrupted, I was about to finish my sentence, and I'll finish it now. Sir Christopher Wren built the St. Paul's Cathedral.
What are the 39 steps?
Not did you answer that? You!
What
you did not answer! Oh, shut up!
Come on, man! Answer me!
The 39 steps!
Oh, that's the man you want, Detective Albright!
I don't think so. Hey, I don't think so. You don't disobey!
was your story, Hannay. You thought this was your story, Hannay. I'm afraid not. This is my story. And I decide how it ends, Hannay. I decide. You don't get to destroy me, Hannay. I get to destroy you, Hannay. You lose, Hannay. I win. And you don't get the girl, Hannay, do you? You get no love, Hannay. You don't get the girl. Hannay loses the girl. You thought you found love, Hannay. You thought you found love. Never, ever, in all eternity, will you ever find love, Hannay. Well, where are you?
I'm right here.
Oh, whoa.
You know, I have quite the punching power. They used to call me Iron Hannay.
You think?
Wait, I'm the protagonist of this story. You aren't supposed to punch me like that.
This is my story, Hannay. And you served the fatherland well.
No.
Who shot him?
Was it you? No, maybe it was you. Now you have that damnation look in your face. It was you, wasn't it?
Oh, come on. Answer me. Who shot him?
Wait. Sir? No.
I'm sorry, mate.
It's been lovely spending 2 years of Christmas Eve with you.
It's been 2 years since you escaped from those 39 steps to a
rock. Those darn 39 steps. But you know what? Let's forget them all. You wouldn't have asked tonight. You would have shared a dance with me.
Unanswered. What exactly are the 39 steps? If anyone has that question, please raise your hand and ask me. Yes, sir, what was that, sir?
What are the 39 steps?
What are the 39 steps? Oh, to tell you the truth, even I don't know. Great night, thank you.
Thank you for being with us here this evening. We hope you enjoyed the show as much as we enjoyed performing it for you. Thank you once again and have a good night.